In fact, Anilesh, speaking about that conversation that you did have with this British MP, it clearly states how she, in a way, tried to create this narrative of being victimized by India, and now she has landed up in Pakistan. So what are we expecting next? Will she, in fact, through her press conference, try to yet again be projected as a victim who was rejected, despite the fact that she did not have proper documents to be in the country?
Well, that has already started. I mean, again, if you see the statements after she was deported to Dubai, she has been speaking to the media houses of her own country, where she has been complaining about how she was treated. She's not talking about the validity of the visa, but she's talking about how the officers treated her when she came to Delhi. Therefore, she's trying to paint a picture of India as a country which did not allow her to enter the premises despite having valid documents. So in a way, that's an attempt to malign India. That's what I would understand, at least, without getting into too much of details. But what is important here to note is that she chairs this committee which talks about the human rights in Kashmir. But imagine a situation, I mean, anybody would laugh, a student of diplomacy or foreign policy would laugh on that she actually chose to go to Pakistan to talk about the human rights violations which is perpetrated by the Indian authorities. I mean, there couldn't be anything more ironical than this, that she's going to hold a press. I'm sorry, I'm laughing. This is absolutely joke that she has made of international diplomacy. She is going to talk about, quote unquote, the plights of people in Kashmir.
Right, right. And in fact, Anilesh, stay with us. We'll go across to strategic expert Sushant Sareen, who's joining us over the phone line. Sir, your first reaction on how Republic TV have accessed this picture of this British MP being in Pakistan. Clearly, she has been exposed. Her hidden agenda finally has been off, in a way, maligning India and its image, and now propagating that in Pakistan.
No, in fact, her visit to Pakistan was always on the cards, and Indians knew about it, and which was one of the reasons why she was unceremoniously parceled out of India. And I think it's good that she's gone to Pakistan, because nothing justifies the action that the government of India took against this person than her subsequent moves to go to Pakistan. That is what she was wanting to do in the first instance. She wanted to come into India and badmouth India. And then she has the temerity and the audacity to say that she's a friend of India. I don't know, who needs enemies if you have friends like this? Because for a person who questions India's territorial integrity and sovereignty, for a person who hobnobs with India's enemies to undermine India, I think the step which was taken by the government of India was exactly the step that should have been taken. For far too long, people like these busybodies in the UK and other countries have been, playing these games. And it's about we shut them down. They can continue to go into a basket case like Pakistan and whatever money she can get out of that place or whatever votes she can get from the Pakistanis in Britain. If that's her politics, she is most welcome to doing it. But she's not going to do it at our expense. And I think thank you to her for actually justifying what the government of India did.
Absolutely. Thank you so much, Sushant Sareen, for joining us on Republic TV. Now, let's go across to my colleague, Tejinder, who joins us live on this broadcast. So, Tejinder, in a way, this has exposed the agenda of this British MP that she had from the very beginning, where she had maintained was trying to be victimized in this entire matter by India. But it seems like her being in Pakistan clearly has clarified a lot of things for us.
See, Richa, yes, she stands exposed, and the Republic TV has got the list of all those members who have already landed in Pakistan, and these are Debbie Abraham, MP Chair, APGK, that is All Parties Parliamentary Group on Kashmir. Then she's also accompanied by Imran Hussain. He's also MP, and he's the Senior Vice Chair of the APPGK and Shadow Justice Minister. He's from the Labour Party. Then there is James Daly, MP. He's the treasurer of APPGK. Then there is a Lord Qurban Hussain. He's the secretary of APPGK. Then there is Tahir Ali, MP. He's the vice chair of APPGK. Then there is Sarah Britcliffe. She's also MP. Mark Eastwood, he's also an MP. Judy Cummins, she's also an MP. Yasmin Dar, member Labour Party. So these are the members. There are around 13 people who have already landed in Pakistan, and they all are the members of, they are one way or the other, they are associated with all parties' parliamentary group on Kashmir. We know that Debbie Abraham's proposed visit to India, when she was deported, she was not allowed to enter India. She was deported from New Delhi airport. Her purpose was to malign India. Her purpose was to propagate fake narrative on Kashmir. Though the MEA sources had confirmed to Republic that Miss Debbie Abraham, she was deported because the government of India knew her intention was that she was supposed to indulge in anti-India activities. And what more proof you need when a day after being deported from India, she lands in Pakistan. And in Pakistan, sometime from now at around 2:30 Pakistani time, she will be holding a press conference along with the Foreign Minister of Pakistan, Shah Mahmood Qureshi. So clearly her intentions are exposed. Though she, after being deported, she said that she is pro-human right activist. Where is her pro-human right activities when it comes to atrocities that are being committed on the people in Pakistan-occupied Kashmir, the atrocities that are being committed on the people of Balochistan, and also on the minorities in Pakistan, whose girls are forced, they are kidnapped, they are forced to convert and forced to marry the members of the Muslim community. So clearly, it seems that the Miss Debbie Abraham, she's spreading a false narrative of Pakistan. Her hypocrisy also stands exposed when she has not uttered a single word about the atrocities on minorities in Pakistan. But we all know that her entire press conference she is going to address with Shah Mahmood Qureshi would focus on Kashmir and on her deportation from India. We know that this press conference is nothing more but her efforts to malign the image of India. But the people across the globe, they all know the intentions of Debbie Abraham. They all know the intentions of Pakistan government.
So clearly, Tejinder, this is a big expose that we have in fact been access to here on Republic TV, where this British MP has been completely exposed of her agenda that she had against India. Now she's in Pakistan. We'll get you more details, viewers. Thank you so much, Tejinder and Anilesh. At this point, we'll keep coming back to you for more.